Claudia George Show and the Pigeon. Our topic tonight, ride or die relationships. Would you stick with your mate through thick and thin? What's too much to handle in a relationship? Give us a call, 877-2106-106. You're listening to Sirius 106, XM 149, Method Man and... what's her name?
Mary J. Blige.
Mary J. Blige. Mary J. I'm a little slow today. You guys are going to have to bear with me today. Had a very, very, very rough weekend. Went to Raging Waters Park.
Yes.
Celebrating Porsche's birthday week.
Yes, sir.
And went on a ride, and it went all bad. Eyes
what happened?
My eyes started burning, but then before I left the park, I had like a rash on the side of my face.
Oh, my goodness.
Woke up the next morning, and that's why I didn't come to your thing, because that night I was like, let me just take a shower. I laid down. I woke up the next day, and my eyes were almost swollen shut, and I had bumps all over my face, and then I tried to go hiking anyways. And 5 minutes into it, I had chest pains.
Oh, wow.
And my throat started closing up on me, and I had to go to the emergency room.
Wow.
And they immediately stuck an IV in my arm and gave me steroids, and they gave me Benadryl. And my friend Bernadette was with me, and she was freaking out. She's like, I thought I was going to see my friend die. Because I started, when they give you Benadryl through an IV, I don't know if you guys ever had it, it's nothing like taking the medicine. It's like times a thousand.
Right.
Wow. Like, as soon as the needle goes in your arm, like, it immediately hits your bloodstream, and you feel, like, overwhelmed. Like, you feel, like, a whoosh, go over you, and instantly drowsy, and you feel it. It works right away.
You said steroids. Is the voice going to get any deeper?
I hope not.
Okay. I'm just saying, we can't afford that.
little mustache growing in. Anyways, our topic, it made me think, like, how I looked at them. I looked in the mirror, and I cried, and then I looked like a monster, and I started thinking about it. I'm like, damn.
We got a lot of pictures of her in
sure
the ER
like
this year.
Yeah, wow. We need to make her an ER album.
Album.
It's my fifth time in the emergency room since November.
It's a lot. It's a lot.
Fifth time.
Something's in the water, CJ. I don't know
what it is.
I don't do the water parks.
It's not just water, though. Okay, this time was a water park. Last time me and Portia left Roscoe's, got in a head-on collision with somebody. Yeah. Someone hit us.
Yeah.
Then it was a tooth infection, so I was going to die. I could have died. It's just. I said on Twitter, whoever has the voodoo doll of me, please make a truce.
Can you stop?
Please.
Can you,
right.
Come on. Maybe it's Flora's ex's cousin's uncle that's doing something to you.
I'm just saying.
Could be Monkey Boy. Who knows?
When you go through something like this, and, you know, I don't have anybody special in my life right now. I'm solo. My career is my meat. But I started to think about it. I'm like, damn, it's a shame that I don't have anyone that could, like, go through this with me. Right. But if I did, would he have left me when he caught sight of my face? Because there's a lot of, I got to thinking about, you know, when you go through things in life, like, okay, if a guy got with you because of looks or what have you, and then that changes. Yeah. Or you have a great body and then you lose that. Or maybe you're in an accident, you're disfigured. Right. I wonder, like, who would ride it out? I guess that's when love is really tested.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know, and there's some great examples of that. And then there's some awful examples of people that just kick rocks when it happens. Have any of you been in a relationship where something about your mate changed and you, like, rode with it or you want to bounce? Anybody?
Yes. My ex was hit with weights on his face, and like a portion of his eyelid, like the meat was coming off, his eyeball was kind of popping out. And we went to the emergency room, and I remember like one of his first questions he said was, are you going to leave me? Like, he was really worried he was going to stay like that, and he was really worried.
Did you say, well, it depends, you have insurance?
And I really...
can we get a claim on this?
And it's funny, because our relationship was already going sour. Like, I was already ready to leave.
Wow.
It was like, if I leave right now, you're going to think it's because your eyeball.
Perfect timing.
Wow. Right. But you already wanted to kick rocks.
I already wanted to kick rocks.
So actually, the injury made you stay around longer.
I stayed around longer, exactly. I stayed around longer.
He did it on purpose.
Exactly. You know, I was sleeping when it happened. I'm starting to believe
I have a similar... Well... You guys know I was proposed to once.
Yes.
And the day I got proposed to, I was going to break up. Like, I was thinking about saying, I think we need to have some space. And my mother was in town. His family was in town. He got injured in his sporting event.
In whatever sport.
Yes. That day.
Exactly.
That day. And that day busted out with the ring.
Oh.
And I was like,
let me think about it.
But actually, same situation. I stayed around another year waiting for him to get back on his feet because I felt like if I left now, I would look awful. I would look like, you know, the monster. Like, oh, things went bad and now you're out. But really, I already felt like it wasn't the right situation for me anyways. Like, I cared about him, but I knew I wasn't going to marry him.
And that's us looking at perception, how people are going to perceive us.
We shouldn't care.
We shouldn't care. Exactly.
But you see women that leave guys that, like, no longer in the league, or maybe they're not acting anymore, or what have you, or whatever the situation is, and people will say that about them, not knowing that there may very well may have been a million things before that.
Right.
And, you know, and a lot of times, like Tina, both of us, we stayed longer because of this.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Flora?
Never happened to me. Ever.
on either side?
On either side. Let's say it did. Yeah. Let's say you were with someone and, you know, he was in a car accident and his face, half his face was burned.
Gosh.
But the other half was beautiful.
Wow.
The other half.
Well, I guess I'm going to just have to talk to the other half. No, I'm just...
Do you think you would stay?
Honestly,
or
I don't
loved
think,
him?
No, honestly, I don't think I have it in me. Well, I think it would also depend on how much I love this individual.
You loved him.
I did.
Yeah, you loved him.
For real.
He's like your soulmate. He's like the guy that you talked to years ago. The guy you talked to.
Okay.
Right now, he's like, let's get together. Y'all get together. And then...
If it was that dude, yes.
Okay.
Yes, that dude. Only that dude.
Whoever that dude is, shout out.
So you have certain people that you would and certain people you would not.
Well, definitely that dude I'm talking about is ride or die. That nigga did a lot for me. A lot.
Which guy are we talking about? The one you
put
through
school? Yes.
Oh, he did a lot for you?
She said he was fine, too.
You did a lot for him.
Well, yes, I did, too. Yes. Because we loved each other. But we did a lot for each other.
Mm-hmm. But you're kind of on both sides of the fence. So would you or wouldn't you?
For that dude, I'd stay. Everything else, I don't have it in me to stay. I know I don't.
You don't think you'll ever love like that again?
No. I know I haven't.
I think you should get with him.
I think you're blocking your blessing.
You sent me an email saying that you feel like if something bad happened to you, you don't expect the person to stick around for you?
Yeah, no, I don't.
You really believe it?
No, I don't. If I don't expect it from myself, I don't expect it from somebody else. No.
Okay. Wow, okay.
I get your self-esteem up.
Right.
Porsche coming.
There's love out there. No.
Don't get defensive.
No, I'm just saying. You make it seem like it's bad. It's not.
No, we're not.
Okay.
We make it seem like it's bad? We're talking about abortions, being bad, all kinds of stuff.
About self-esteem there. What the hell?
You got to think self-esteem. It'd be nice to want to expect your man, the person.
Yeah, it'd be nice to want to expect, but then it's even worse when it doesn't happen. Then you let down.
So just don't expect it.
Thank you. There you go. No.
I'm not agreeing with you. Don't worry.
No. I'm just saying that's my point.
Okay. My cousin, you talk about burning, she was burned by like 70% of her body, half of her face, her arms, everywhere. And her husband stuck with it. They had no kids at the time. They were just dating. They're now married. They have three beautiful kids and he stuck with it. He didn't care. And it was like, it didn't matter, but I can understand how it could be, tedious because she would always be at the hospital at the doctor because the burns were so severe. Yeah. I know they would be pussing and bleeding. Like it's not a nice process. And I really respect him as a man for sticking in there, especially seeing, quote unquote, men are visual. If your girl does not look how she looked before and all of a sudden it's kind of like, that gives them an out to want to leave.
That's absolutely commendable.
I definitely respect him because she was burned pretty bad.
Wow. I got a good question for you because we've talked about this on air. The guy that you loved, the like main person that was in your life, and he passed away.
Right.
And how did he pass away?
He got shot.
Okay. Yes. Let's say he was shot and he were just paralyzed.
Right.
He was still here today.
Right.
Do you think you would still be with him?
Yeah.
You do.
Yeah. Paralyzation, I think, is that's. I'd rather have him paralyzed than dead. Right. I'd rather have him injured than dead. I'd rather have him blind than dead or deaf than dead.
But you would still be with him.
He's still here. Yes.
And
who knows how that would have turned out.
Well, I wonder if that perspective's changed because he isn't here. You'd give anything to have him here. But if he really was here, would you? Because you're so young, too.
Right.
That's a long time to be with that person.
And what if you want kids?
From my point of view, that wouldn't be broke now. I mean, yeah, you could still.
There's a lot of guys that aren't in wheelchairs and shit doesn't work.
Right.
What about that guy that was in a wheelchair that's this porn or some shit?
Oh, yeah.
There's
all the possibilities. What do you know about that, Shelly?
No, she did some Maury show.
They really, there's a in a wheelchair.
When I did one of my Maury show appearances, there was a guy there. He's called Sex on Wheels, I think. Dick on Wheels.
Nice.
He has a MySpace page. Look him up, dickonwheels.com.
Wow.
And he turned a negative into a positive. He had a normal, active sex life. And then he got paralyzed, and now he gets it even more. And somebody pull it up online. You got to check him out.
Okay.
He gets it in. I mean, he's not.
Wow.
I mean, he's not.
Did you see? Did he?
He's not. How should I say? Putting his back into it.
Uh-huh.
But he. He is doing it.
That is wrong.
Funny. And
he's doing it and making
levels.
A profit off of it.
He's the first man, like.
In porn. Wheelchair.
Wow. Mm-hmm. He's a pioneer.
So the girl has to be pretty flexible. She's trying to work it.
You gotta make sure the brakes are, your brake game always.
Yeah, you gotta make sure the brakes is on, so you don't roll nowhere.
Right. Yeah. We have our first caller.
Let's get him on the show.
We have Tony from LA with an I. Must be a girl. Welcome to the show, Tony.
Thank you very much. How y'all doing?
Never mind.
Hey,
how you doing, Tony?
Good. I was just calling because it has nothing to do with the subject you're talking about. I just wanted to know, Claudia, what is it when you say what? How fast is your 40 time? I don't understand that. What that means?
Good God.
It's because, you know, I dated a football player for a year from 07 to 08, and, you know, I may have been in a couple photographs with a couple others. So, you know, I have an affinity for athletic men. So they tease me all the time and say that you have to have a good 40 time to get with me, implying that I only date professional football players who run under a 4.5. It's total exaggeration.
Bogus.
Yes. So that's what that joke comes from, because they just put that on me. Like, that's my character on the show.
Right. That's her. Yeah. Shout out to Claudia at the ESPY Awards.
Yes. I was doing research because I like to work in sports.
Come on, Flora.
I did not give my number to one pro athlete at the ESPYs.
Thank you so much for calling, Tony.
Nothing, actually. Was that it? That's your only question? Okay.